Hey, welcome sports fans back at Mr. B's here on a beautiful Thursday afternoon. He is Tim Sitzmann. I am Chris Williams. We're at 1995 Northwest 86th Street in Clive. Big tent sale going on.
That's why I'm casual. You know, Chris, you usually see me in a tie.
I've never seen him in a suit.
But I'm ready to go. We're going to be out under the big top. You know, we got the three tents out there. We're going to have full merchandise at great values. Invite all you fanatics to come on in and say hello and pick up a value today.
Oh, man.
Through Saturday at Mr. B.
You got to see it, everybody. I mean, the good stuff going. Setting out, it's all over the place.
And what a beautiful day.
Oh,
it's wonderful out there. So we're going to have a good time today. Come on and see us.
Just perfect. The only thing you're missing is some hot dogs being grilled.
Well, we probably should have done that, but maybe they could bring some with you.
Come on over, Mr. B's, 1995 Northwest 86th Street in Clive. All right, Tim, you and I were doing our thing. It's a little series we're putting together.
Absolutely.
Here. Taking a first look at all of Iowa State's opponents in 2010. We've already done Northern Illinois and Iowa.
Yep.
You have Iowa State starting out the season 1-1.
1-1.
Third game of the year. This one got swapped with the Utah game. Iowa State will start conference play on September 18th at Arrowhead Stadium.
Big game against
Kansas State. Now, Bill Snyder, Kansas State's head coach, earlier this week of Media Days, just to give everyone a little bit of background, they have who I consider probably, the best running back in the Big 12.
Pretty good.
Daniel Thomas.
Right.
Good running back.
Right.
They don't have a quarterback. There's a young man named Carson Kaufman, who I kind of thought would have the edge. Bill Snyder, as he likes to do, maybe he was playing a joke on the media, I don't know, but he told the media, they don't really have a quarterback, and it's open competition going into camp next week. This is my thought on Kansas State. I like competition. I'm all for competition. But I also want my quarterback known as I go into the first week of camp.
Right.
That's just me.
Right.
Pretty tough. As Steve Dace likes to say a lot of times, you can't fake your quarterback, okay? That's one thing you can't fake people out.
He's exposed all the time.
Yeah, and you know what? This makes me feel better about Iowa State. I'm going to take Austin Arnaud and the Cyclones. There's no way after Iowa State gave that thing away last year. There's no way they do it again this year.
No, I'm on your side on this one, and I think it's going to be a 10-point game.
Mm-hmm.
I think the Cyclones are going to go in there with a little revenge in mind, and that, you know, we travel well. The Fanatics will be down there. We had a great crowd last year,
mm-hmm.
and I think this year will be no different than that.
I think it'll be better this year.
I really do too.
Because people are so excited about, you know, the bowl win and just the program in general. I think that the crowd will be a lot better this
time. It'll be electric. And I see us coming out of Game 3 being 2-1. And a big win as far as the ability to keep that record going for a possible bowl bid at the end.
And you gotta basically, you really need to. This is a huge game to me because, off the top of my head, I don't think Iowa State even plays a road game in the Big 12 North. This is really the only one that won't be played.
Right.
Well, okay, I take that back. Colorado is on the schedule, but this is a game neutral site. It's a team that most pundits have Iowa State back and forth with in their preseason standings. To me, if Iowa State, the only chance they have to go to a bowl game, they have to sweep the Sunflower State, beat Kansas, and beat Kansas State. These two games I have circled on my calendar.
Right, right. And I actually think they're probably, the coaching staff's probably looking the same way you are at the season and breaking it down. And if you get an upset here or there, which I'm hoping we can do, then you're home free. But you got to win those two.
And when you want to get to the type of a program that Paul Rhodes wants, this is a game you should win. This is a game you should win. I mean, you can't lose a game like this if you want to go to bowl games consistently.
Just can't. So I pick it, you know, I pick it a 20-10 ball game, 10 points, 21-10, 10, 11 points.
Yeah.
I think, again, Austin Arnaud has got the nod, and over the quarterback we don't even know, as you said.
It'll probably be the Kaufman kid, but still.
And he's untested.
He got benched after four games last year
for a
guy who's gone on and graduated. So I don't think he's a bad quarterback, but I look at that roster. I see Daniel Thomas, who's a great running back. But I'm talking, you know, there's not a lot of options for Kaufman to go to. Their offensive line is decent at Kansas State. You know, it's basically that offense to me is going to go as far as their running back takes.
Right.
So I'm going to pick a win as well.
Good. I think we're safe there, and I hope there's more coming down the pike.
All right,
as
Tim.
We go through this season.
Hey, we're gonna talk about the Northern Iowa game first thing tomorrow morning. But Tim, what time are you closing down here tonight?
Well, we go from 10 to 7 today, and thanks for mentioning our sidewalk sale. We're always excited about it. We do it annually, and it's the best values of the season. We bring together the three stores that we have: the Bedauer store, the Backroom store, and Mr. B's. Put it out on the sidewalk. Great selection, great prices, great fun. 3 days, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, must see.
All right. We're going to stop on in. Tim, we'll see you in the morning. Stop by Mr. B's at 1995 Northwest 86th Street in Clyde.
And we got the Clones 2-1 going out of this season.
2-1. Yep. Will they beat the Northern Iowa Panthers? We'll see. Stop by tomorrow morning and check it out.